Hello friends, I'm here with my channel Solving Questions with Gauri Ma'am. As you know, here we solve questions from IIT JAM examination from biotechnology paper. So let's start solving. Today the question we are going to have is from MCQ type of question. This is a multiple choice question. Total question in the section are 30 questions are there. This is a section A from the IIT JAM examination. Here first 10 questions are for 1 mark, so 10 marks for its first 10 questions. Then next 20 questions are there, that is for 2 marks each. So in all there are the 40 marks for the for this 20 questions. So we will have total marks for this section 50 marks would be there for section A from the MCQ type of questions. Remember that there is a negative marking for this section, so you have to be very careful by clicking the answer because there is a negative marking. And as this is a MCQ type of question, there is a four options would be given and one choice would be a correct answer. So you have to click on the correct choice. Let's start with my question. The question is from paper of Biotechnology 2020. The question is asking protein that helps other proteins to fold correctly eats. Chaperone, proteasome, ubiquitin, desmosome. These are the four options given, and this is a MCQ type of question, so one of the four options would be a correct answer. You must have gone through this question. I have given this question in my last video. You can contact me on the on my mail ID. This is my mail ID. I conduct online classes for the preparation of IIT JAM examination. If you wish, you can contact me on this my mail. Also, you can write your answer in the comment section. Let's understand one by one what are the options given in our question. So first option is the chaperone, which are the proteins which help in protein folding. Remember that this chaperone assists the conformational folding or unfolding of the protein. Chaperones are also involved in assembly and disassembly of other macromolecular structures to the protein. And these are primarily concerned with the protein folding. So chaperones are involved in the protein folding. Here we have shown that this is a endoplasmic reticulum is this. Here the ribosome are attached to ER. The protein synthesis is going on this ribosome. As this is a secretory protein, this protein is simultaneously transported into the ER. Here modification and folding means once this protein is transported into ER, the chaperone certainly get attached to this transported protein. That says protein that wait for some time, fold properly, don't make hurry in your folding. So that this protein get folded in a proper way. This correctly folded protein further get transported by packing into the vesicle to the Golgi complex, which usually we study in a protein trafficking. This protein get transported to Golgi complex. This is a properly folded protein. So here the role of chaperone is very important, which assists the conformational folding of the protein. Now, if this protein is misfolded, it's not getting folded properly, then it is gumming out of the ER and it is added to this ubiquitin proteasome system, which is involved in the degradation of protein. We'll see this just now. So remember this, if this is misfolded, then it is going to add it through this system for the degradation. Here the thing you should remember, that how the protein is going to fold, that is already written in during the primary structure of the protein. The primary structure of protein, we see that there is an amino acid sequence, and in amino acid we know that some are hydrophobic amino acids, some are hydrophilic amino acid. So in that way it is already decided that how this protein is going to be folded. But chaperones are there to help them in the folding. Chaperone doesn't decide the folding of protein, but that just helps this protein for its proper folding. So in the earlier figure, what we have seen, that chaperone help protein folding during the protein translation. This is the figure which explains us after translation is complete how the protein are get folded using the chaperone. This is an example from E. coli. Chaperone are present ubiquitously. They are present in E. coli, that is in prokaryotes, in eukaryotes, as well as it is present in archaea also. So this is the example from prokaryote E. coli. This is a HSP60, which is also known as GRO-EL, and this is GRO-ES. So this is a GRO-EL-ES complex, which is involved in a protein folding. Now see here, this is a two units, subunits of this GRO-EL, which are attached with each other in a inverted manner. This just like a box like structure is this, and this is cap. Like this is a magic box, the protein is getting added in this, and properly folded is protein is coming out of the box. You can remember this figure in this way, that GRO-EL is a like a box, incorrectly or unfolded protein, incompletely folded protein is added to this region. Hydrophobic protein binding sites are there at the edges of this GRO-EL protein. ATP is required. GRO-ES cap is attached. This chaperon, this is GRO-EL is a chaperon. This chaperon provides the microenvironment for the proper folding of this protein. Now this protein inside, it gets properly folded. ATP hydrolysis takes place. This GRO-ES removes, and this correctly folded protein now coming out of this GRO-EL complex. So this is just like a magic box. Just now I have told you that protein is getting inserted and magically it is coming out now, which is properly folded or correctly folded. So this is the another way how the chaperone helps in the proper protein folding. Now coming to next option, the next option is proteasome. So see this figure, this is a native protein. Let's consider that this is the protein which is not folded properly. Now what happens in a cell, this is improperly folded protein, it's packed with ubiquitin. This yellow figure is giving the structure of ubiquitin. This is ubiquitin packed protein, then it is added to this proteasome assembly. This is a proteasome assembly which is formed with the alpha and beta ring structures. It is two rings, alpha and beta. These are alpha are made up of 7 subunits, beta are also made up of 7 subunits. And these combinedly stacked on each other and forming this barrel shape structure. In this barrel, the improperly folded protein is added. When it is added, ubiquitin are removed. And in this, this beta subunit is having protease activity. So using this protease activity, the protein is get degraded and coming out. So it is degraded protein coming out of this. This alpha subunits are just like a gate. It is receiving the protein and through alpha subunit at this bottom, the protein broken down protein or amino acid sequences are coming out. So in this way, this proteasome works. So this is involved in protein degradation and not in a protein folding. See, this is another figure in this ubiquitin proteasome pathway is shown. See here, this ubiquitin is there. Ubiquitin, this is again a, you can say, unfolded or improperly folded protein. To this ubiquitin is attached. This is attached either one by one or in a chain. The attachment of this ubiquitin is at the amino acid lysine, or it can be a cysteine. This ubiquitin can be attached on serine or threonine residues also. And once this is attached, this is decided that this protein has to be degraded. This proteasome assembly is there, as we have seen in last image, and ATP is required for the removal of this ubiquitin. This get added to this proteasome assembly and degraded protein is coming out of from the another side of this proteasome. These are 7 to 8 amino acid sequences. This is coming out and which can be further degraded into individual amino acid. These amino acid can be recycled for the another protein synthesis, or this is the protein from any antigen which is coming from outside. So these antigen can be used for their antigen presentation. So in this way, this ubiquitin proteasome assembly or ubiquitin proteasome pathway works for the degradation of protein. The last option in the question is desmosome. See, here two cells are shown, and in between the structure, this is in between the extracellular space, the structure is known as desmosome is present, which is there for the cell to cell adhesion. This is required for cell to cell adhesion. This is this is made up of cadherin protein. These are the cadherin protein shown here. Some linker proteins are also there, and it is having keratin intermediate filaments as well. So these are required for the cell to cell adhesion. So these desmosomes are, we find this desmosome in cardiac muscle tissues, bladder tissue, gastrointestinal mucosa, and in epithelial cells, we find this desmosome. This is important for intense mechanical stress, which is there in these all these tissues. So for this stress to cope up with this stress, this desmosome are important. So we can say that desmosome don't have any role during the protein folding. It is required for the to sustain with a intense mechanical stress. Here I have summarized whole video. So the first option says chaperone, this is for protein folding. Another option is proteasome, this is the assembly for degradation of improper proteins. Then ubiquitin is the next option. It is a tag. Remember, this is a tag and this is an assembly where the protein is degraded. Ubiquitin is a tag attached to the protein which is to be degraded through proteasome assembly. And desmosome is quite different. It's a cell structure for cell to cell adhesion. So it doesn't have any role in protein folding. So the answer for the given question would be option A, that is a chaperone, which is required for protein folding. Now this is a question for my next video. The question is from paper of biotechnology 2020. Question is from cell biology. Cell division is the topic very precisely. See what is the question. The correct sequence of phases during mitosis is. The options are prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. Prophase, anaphase, metaphase, telophase. Anaphase, prophase, metaphase, telophase. And anaphase, metaphase, prophase, telophase. So four options are given. Question is MCQ type of question and one of the option is correct. So you find the correct answer for this question. We'll discuss this in my next video. I hope you like my videos very much. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. Hit the bell icon. This motivates me very much when I see much views are there and I see likes are there. Thanks for watching. Thank you. Bye.